Hey, what's up, you guys, and welcome back to Gal. Today, we're going to be breaking down 5 cool music video effects for you using Premiere Pro. And if you guys are new here, please consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell so you're notified when I publish new tutorials each week. For the first music video effect, I'm covering how to create an animated letterbox as seen in the music video Old Town Road by Lil Nas X. Now, I love this effect and it's pretty simple to do, so let's go ahead and jump in. What we want to do is create a color mat first to create the letterbox. So go down to New Item, then go to Color Mat, and it will automatically choose the width and the height of your current sequence that you're working in. So hit OK. And then you can choose the color. In our case, we're going to choose black. That's typically the standard color for a letterbox. And then hit OK. And then we can name this Letterbox. Then hit OK. Now we're going to drag and drop the letterbox on top of the video here in the timeline. Now we want to go to the time in the playhead where we want this black box, the letterbox, to completely disappear. So we're at the 3-second marker. That's a good amount of time for the animation. But first, what we need to do is create a mask using the effect controls. So we're going to go up here underneath opacity and select this 4-point polygon mask. And we're going to get rid of the feathering, so we don't want any feathering, and we're going to invert it. And now we can use this zoom level here and go to 25%, and we're just going to move this rectangle to go beyond the frame here. So I'm just going to quickly do that. So this is the point that we want the animation to stop. Now we want this to start out completely black. So to do that, we're going to hit the stopwatch here because we want this to be the keyframe of the last point of the animation at 3 seconds, right? So now let's move this playhead back. And then this is where you're going to click on the mask name here. And then we're going to bring these down. We're going to bring these down to the center, right? Because it's animating from the center outwards towards the top and the bottom. And you'll have to play around with it until you get the alignment right. Unfortunately, Premiere Pro doesn't have an easy way to align masks right now. I hope that they do this in the future so it's completely straight, but for now we just have to wing it. And now let's zoom in, let's say around 100%, and let's make sure these lines are straight here. Let's get this 75%, there we go. And now I'm just gonna bring these lines together like they're overlapping completely. I'll do it on the other side here too. And then we'll just zoom out to make sure that this is in the center. It looks about right. Now, if we click outside of this mask, you'll see that there's a slight sliver. Now, to get rid of that, all we need to do is on the video clip is right click and select Apply Default Transition. And then this is a cross dissolve, so you can make it shorter or longer. I'm just going to make it slightly shorter. And now when we play this back, there's our animating letterbox. It's that simple. And because of the cross dissolve, we don't see that sliver in the beginning. And for the second effect, I'm showing you how to create a film overlay as seen in Troy Sivan's Bloom music video, where you can see lots of film burns and textures in that 4:3 aspect ratio. And same with Miley Cyrus's recent music video, Mother's Daughter. You also see this frame that's happening, even though it was shot on a 16:9, likely 4K camera, if not higher. And you'll also see film overlays and textures used in famous music videos by Lana Del Rey. As you see here, Summertime Sadness, there's lots of texture and grain. So for this film overlay effect, I'm using film overlays from Smash Workshop. They're pretty cool. You can import them as a folder of assets. So they have film burn loops, they have textures, they have Super 8 loops and frames. So there's this HD frame overlay. I'm just gonna drag and drop it on top and you can just kind of see what it looks like. So this is actually a real film overlay. Now, if we wanted to replicate the effect that we saw in Miley Cyrus's music video as well as Troy Sivan's, we wanna center this. Now, if we center it and we move this over, you can see that there's a little disconnect here and we need to scale it down just a tad bit here to give it more of a frame look. So to fix this white gap here, what we can do is we can also add another color mat on top, just like we did with the letterbox. So let's go ahead and let's create a new color mat and hit OK, make sure it's black. And let's go ahead and drag and drop this on top. Now what we need to do is also create another 4-point polygon mask, and then we can invert this. And now what we're going to do is just place this mask around this area here so we can just see the rounded edges, like so. We'll just make a few more adjustments. We'll get rid of the feathering as well. We don't need any feathering. And let's just get this just right so it looks like it's in the center here. And we can click away just to see if it looks right. All right, cool. So that looks pretty cool. Now the next thing we want to do is we want to add in some texture and some burns. So I'm going to move these layers up because we want the burns and the textures to be within. So let's go ahead and just double click and we can play this back. You can see this is some texture here, some film grain. So let's just drag and drop this underneath. And we need to add a blend mode. So select it, then go up to effects and let's choose screen to get rid of all the black. So now we have some texture. And now we can also add in some burns. So while this is playing, we can roll this back and we can add in a burn. So here is a couple burns. Let's double click to show this one. That one's pretty cool. There's also this burn effect here. So if I take this down, drag it down here, we can apply a multiply effect. And so then it kind of looks more cool here like that, which is pretty sweet. We can add in a different burn. There's this burn effect. And for this one, we can also add a screen to get rid of the black, like so. So, you know, these textures are only so long, but if you wanted them to repeat, you know, you can take this one, hit Alt Option key, drag and drop it to duplicate it. And with this frame and the color mat too, the color mat you can extend out as much as you want, as much as you need it to. But for the frame overlay, you also have to hit Alt Option, click, drag, let go to duplicate it, and then you can roll it back. And then you can just take these two as well, hit Alt Option, drag and drop them over to duplicate it as well. And then you can just align everything here like so. And you can just repeat these overlays throughout the duration of the music video that you want. And in the third effect, I actually haven't seen this effect specifically done in any specific music video, but it's a film strip overlay effect. So it's similar to the one before, but instead we're actually gonna use a 4:3 aspect ratio. So to start, we're gonna create a new sequence in a 4:3 aspect ratio. We're gonna go to new sequence and we're going to create 960 by 720. And you'll see that it's in a 4:3 aspect ratio. And we'll just call this film strip look and hit okay. So now you see it's in a 4:3 aspect ratio. So I'm gonna take this clip here of this guy opening his eyes, drag it into the timeline, keep the existing settings, and we'll just have to reposition this in a second. And then we're going to take the second one of the guy singing with the microphone here. So we'll just drag and drop this down here as well. Now we're going to reposition this down in the frame. So we're just going to scale this down like so. And same with this one. We're gonna scale this down so we can see his microphone in frame. So just like before, we're gonna take the frame overlay and we're gonna drag and drop it on top. We have to scale this down to see it. So now because this is a film strip, we're going to make sure that this fits in that 4:3 aspect ratio. So now we have the film strip look, right? Now the next step is to duplicate this frame. So we're gonna Alt Option click, like so. We can even select all of them, the Alt Option key, and drag it over. So now we have this loop here, but now I'm gonna drag this up. I'm just gonna take these layers up like so. And what we're going to do is fit this video frame inside of that first frame here, like so, just like that. And now I'm gonna duplicate this. I'm gonna click Alt Option again, drag this up. And now I'm gonna move the position up so it's in the second frame right here, like so. And I'm gonna duplicate it one more time. And I'll drag this one down so it's in the bottom frame here, like so. So now we have them playing in a film strip like this, which is pretty cool. Let's do the same thing quickly with this second video clip. Now let's add a Super 8 loop on top of this frame overlay. So we can choose any one of them. I like this one here, so let's just drag and drop this on top. And now we have to rescale this down as well so it fits in the 4:3 aspect ratio. Then let's hit screen, and now it looks like an actual film strip, which looks pretty cool. So right here, actually, at this moment when there's a transition, we can actually cut this. We can take these clips and we can hit shift to select all of them and drag this over. And then we'll bring over this clip of the man singing. So as soon as that burn happens, you get that transition here, which looks pretty cool. Now, if we want to add some more texture, we can certainly add some texture as well. So we can go into the texture loops and say this one's pretty cool. We can go ahead and drag this down here, and we can change this to be a screen. So now we have some texture there. To bring out some of the color with this singer, part of doing music video is to bring out color as well. What we can do is use Lumetric Color. So we can go down to the looks and we can choose maybe this Kodak look, and we can decrease the intensity a bit, bring out some of the vibrancy, and then we can also use curves to bring out some more contrast. So now that looks so much better. You can see the before and after. And then we'll just copy this clip, hit Command C on a Mac or Control C on a PC, and then we can select all of these other clips here by holding down Shift and then right click and paste attributes. So we're gonna paste Lumetric Color. And so now all of them have this more rich color texture. So this next effect is from a Logic music video. You can see that there is a video within another video screen. This is done by masking or using green screen effects. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do in this next effect. The easiest way to do it is to film whatever object that you have, or let's say you have a room full of screens, put a green screensaver on that screen, or put, you know, some sort of green paper on top of that screen so that way you can key it out. So what we're going to do with this clip, it already has a green screen. This is just a stock video clip, and you guys can use other different types of stock video to achieve this, is we're going to go to the effects and we're going to search for ultra key. And I'm going to double click to apply to the clip. And then from the effect controls, we need to take this dropper tool and select the green color here. And then what you can do is you can go into the alpha channel and make sure that everything looks good. You can see there's still some gray area here. So what we can do is we can go down to matte cleanup and we can play around with the contrast here to get rid of that. So now it's a perfect key. We can take it back to composite. Now we need to place a video inside of here. So just drag this video clip up to video layer 2, and then we can go into our stock video here, and I'll take the dancer clip and just drag and drop it down here. Now we can scale this to be within this video frame, which is pretty cool. And so that is the final effect on how you do that. And lastly, but certainly not least, I'm going to show you how to create hand-painted elements on top of video, as you see here in Bruno Mars' famous video. So let's go ahead and jump on in. So I use the handcrafted Smash Pack, part of SmashWorks. Of course, you can use tablets and create your own animations, but that takes a ton of work. So what they've done is they've made a whole pack of these little illustrations that are animated, that are hand-painted, that you guys can overlay in their motion graphics template. So you'll install them in your essential graphics panel, and they appear like this. If you need to install them, you would just hit this little install motion graphics template button in the lower right hand corner. And so then what you can do is you can just drag and drop them in. So the first thing that I used is one of their transitions here. So if I just drag and drop this on top of the timeline, it'll just take a second to install, and you can kind of see all the different transitions and elements that are within this motion graphics template. So the first one that I use is number 9. So you'll just select this, and then you're going to go up to edit here and just type in number 9. So from here you can change the position, the color. I like the yellow color, so I'm actually gonna keep it, but if you need to change it, you just select that and change the color here. To speed this up, what you can do is see how it's a little bit slow for my liking. So once it gets down to the full color bleed, I'll just cut there. And what I typically like to do is I hit R for the rate stretch tool to speed this up. I'm just going to speed this up just by dragging it, and now it's quicker. And then what I can do is to the moment that it starts to bleed back down, I'll just cut there. So I'll go back to C for the cut tool. Then I'll hit V for the arrow tool, and I'll just close that gap there. So then it starts to go much faster, and you can also speed this up again here. You can hit the rate stretch tool R on your keyboard and speed that up a bit. So then it goes down like that. So then here's where you can start to play with different elements, right? So, you know, if he's kicking here, let's say we wanted a bubble to have him pop right here with his foot, we can find one of those elements here. So we can drag down hand painted elements too. Just take a second to import. So number 7 is a good one where it pops. So we'll just go ahead and pick number 7. And then what we can do is reposition this to time with his foot there. And now we just have to align it with the time. So when his foot comes up there, we want it to pop. So here in the timeline, what we can do, and this is one of my favorite tools, hit Alt Option and then use the arrow tools, the little arrow bracket tools, to move this until it is at that right moment. When he kicks it, it starts to pop. Now, if we wanted to duplicate this to have the bubble pop here when he kicks his leg right here, we can just duplicate this by hitting Alt Option, clicking and dragging, and then we can move this bubble element down to when his foot is here. So we can move this down and then to the left a little bit more. And then we just play with the timing again. So he kicks it right there is when we want it to pop. So we're gonna hit Alt Option and use the right bracket. And let's see if that looks good. Yep. So all I did was then I just duplicated these elements. I also went in and found different elements. They have lots of lines, and you can start to build a really cool animated sequence like I have over here in the final product, where there's a bunch of overlaid elements and it creates dynamism, just like you saw in that Bruno Mars music video. And yeah, that is how you do these music video effects. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If we get to 5,000 likes, then I know that you guys like these types of videos. Also, if you guys have seen any cool music video effects in a recent music video that you want me to teach you how to create, just leave a comment below with a link to the video, and I'm going to select 3 of the coolest comments from this video, and you guys will win a handcrafted smash pack that will include all of the film overlays and the dancing elements. So leave a comment below and I'll be sure to select them and let you guys know who the winner is. And lastly, a huge shout out to my long-standing patrons, Io Nemo, Yappy's Email, John Simon, Florian Fries, Christina P, Nami M, and Rick Levine. Thank you guys so much for your support. And if you're interested in my Patreon community, you can join at patreon.com/premieregal and get some awesome perks. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you next time.